Good evening. This is All India Radio, and I'm Tanvi Taneja with the news at 9. The headlines. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman assures Karnataka of all assistance in rebuilding flood-hit Kodagu region. Government approves additional grant of nearly 19 crore rupees for flood-ravaged Kerala. Enforcement Directorate again questions former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram in the Airtel Maxis money laundering case. Delhi High Court overturns acquittal of 20 people in 2010 Mirchpur Dalit killing case in Haryana. United States asks Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan to act decisively against terrorists operating from its soil. And in Asian Games, India thrashed Japan 8-0 in hockey. Bagged 2 gold, 1 silver and 4 bronze on the 6th day. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has assured Kodagu in Karnataka of all assistance in rebuilding the region ravaged by flood and landslides. She also promised that central assistance will be given according to the guidelines of the Disaster Response Fund. Ms. Sitharaman said that she will speak to the Prime Minister and the Home Minister about her assessment. Talking to media in Kodagu District Headquarters, Madikere, today, Ms. Sitharaman said that 1 crore rupees will be given from MPLAD from her side.
Roads have taken a thrashing, complete beating, whether it's the national highway or the state highway or the village connectivity roads. We have to be very careful of how we are going to restore it. I will definitely meet up with Nitin Gadkari on the roads. I will speak to Home Minister because he takes care of the National Disaster Relief Funding, and obviously certainly go back to the Prime Minister to give him a report of what I've seen here and what I've heard from all of you.
The Defence Minister offered to send Indian Army's Border Roads Organisation Task Force to advise the administration on building roads in hilly terrain. Earlier in the day, the Defence Minister visited Kushalnagar and Madhappura and interacted with the persons affected by flood and landslides. More from our correspondent.
According to preliminary estimates, Kodagu has suffered losses worth 1,140 crore rupees. According to the District Deputy Commissioner, P. Srividya, she has said that at least 34 gram panchayats have been badly affected. Apart from the municipalities in Kushalnagar and Madhappura that are situated on the catchment area of Harangi River, the DG and IGP of Police Neelmani Raju has informed in Madikeri today that people will be allowed to return to their villages only after confirmation of safe surroundings. State government has meanwhile appointed a team comprising of 9 probationers, IAS officers to supervise relief works in Kodagu. They all belong to the 2017 batch. Sudhindra, AIR News, Bengaluru.
The Union Health Ministry has approved an additional grant of 18 crore and 71 lakh rupees to flood-affected Kerala for disbursing to village health, sanitation and nutrition committees. The grant will be given under the National Health Mission. In a tweet, the ministry said the grant has been approved as per the request of the state government. Meanwhile, Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan today said a preliminary estimate of losses due to floods in the state is around 20,000 crore rupees. In a statement, he said the state was facing the biggest calamity in 100 years and the actual losses will steadily go up once the water recedes and the final assessment is made. The Chief Minister informed that more than 26,000 houses have been damaged or destroyed and crops spread over 40,000 hectares lost. Mr. Vijayan added that the state has lost more than 2 lakh poultry and at least 46,000 milk animals. The Chief Minister said telecommunication network and electricity lines have been damaged. He said the power sector suffered losses of around 750 crore rupees, while damage to water supply infrastructure was close to 900 crore rupees. Housing and Urban Affairs Ministry has approved the construction of over 1,12,000 more affordable houses for the benefit of the urban poor under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban PMAYU. An official release said the approval was given in the 37th meeting of the Central Sanctioning and Monitoring Committee held in New Delhi. The ministry said Andhra Pradesh has been sanctioned over 37,000 houses, Haryana over 19,000, Madhya Pradesh 18,000, Maharashtra 12,000, Chhattisgarh 10,000 and Karnataka over 8,000 houses. The ministry said approvals given for Jammu and Kashmir stands at over 4,000, while Arunachal Pradesh has been sanctioned 188 houses. With these proposed houses, the total number of cumulative houses under PMAYU will be over 54,95,000. The Enforcement Directorate today again questioned former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram in the Airtel Max's money laundering case. Official sources said Chidambaram's statement will be recorded under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. The agency wants to put across a fresh set of questions to him regarding the deal. The agency had earlier recorded statements of the now-defunct Foreign Investment Promotion Board, FIPB, officials when the deal took off. Chidambaram's son, Karthi, has also been questioned by the ED twice in this case. The agency had said that the FIPB approval in the Airtel Max's FDI case was granted in March 2006 by Chidambaram, even though he was competent to accord approval on project proposals only up to 600 crore rupees, and beyond that it required the approval of the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will attend the two-day BIMSTEC summit in Nepal from the 30th of this month. Briefing media in New Delhi, Secretary East in the External Affairs Ministry, Preeti Saran, said the Prime Minister will hold separate bilateral meetings with the participating leaders of the member countries. Improving connectivity and further strengthening relations within the BIMSTEC will be high on the agenda. Ways to counter terrorism and radicalization may be discussed during the summit. Several MOUs in different areas are expected to be inked during the summit. Ms. Sarun said, declaration to give further roadmap to the BIMSTEC will be issued at the end of the summit.
There is a declaration that is under negotiations. There are other documents which are also under negotiations. I'm not sure how many of them will be actually ready for signing, but certainly we look forward to a declaration that should be issued at the end, which will give further roadmap to BIMSTEC as a regional grouping and build on the work that has been done in the last 21 years.
The National Investigation Agency, NIA, has arrested Manipur Congress MLA Yamthung Haukip in a missing arms case. In a statement, the agency said the MLA was arrested for his alleged involvement in procuring police pistols illegally and distributing them to different terrorist groups to wage war against the state. The NIA has been investigating a case related to the theft of 56 pistols and 58 magazines from the DG Pool Armory located within the premises of the 2nd Manipur Rifles Battalion, Imphal. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts. The Delhi High Court today overturned the acquittal of 20 persons in the 2010 Mirchpur Dalit killing case. A bench of Justices S. Muralidhar and I. S. Mehta held that there was deliberate targeting of houses of the members of the Valmiki community by members of the Jat community. The bench said the fine amounts collected from the convicts shall be utilized by the Haryana government as part of the provision of pecuniary relief and rehabilitation to the victims. The High Court also upheld the conviction of 13 persons by the trial court and enhanced the punishment of some of the convicts. The High Court pronounced the verdict on the appeal of 13 persons challenging their conviction. More from our Chandigarh correspondent.
The incident occurred in 2010 when violent clash between two sections of society started in Mirchpur village of Hisar district. More than 24 houses were set on fire and 70-year-old scheduled caste man and his physically challenged daughter were burned to death. Violence started after exchange of words on a petty issue between the two sections. Ashwini Kumar Sharma, AIR News, Chandigarh.
The BJP today demanded an apology from Congress President Rahul Gandhi for his remarks against the BJP and RSS in London. Briefing media in New Delhi, party spokesperson Sambit Patra criticized Mr. Gandhi for comparing the BJP and the RSS with the Muslim Brotherhood of Egypt. He alleged that Mr. Gandhi is doing vote bank politics and by making such remarks, he is tarnishing the image of the country. He said, the only facet that Mr. Gandhi possesses is hatred against Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the BJP and the RSS. Mr. Patra said, the vision of the present government is Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas.
आरएसएस ने अगर कुछ बदला है, भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने कुछ अगर बदला है, तो वो केवल गरीबों को अमीर बनाने के लिए जो सोच होनी चाहिए, गरीबों को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए जो सोच होनी चाहिए, उसी सोच को आगे बढ़ाया है।
Mr. Patra said, it seems Mr. Gandhi is frustrated due to the popularity of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the BJP. He said the Congress president has no maturity and understanding of the country. In Gujarat, over 1,15,000 beneficiaries have been allotted houses under the Pradhan Mantri Grameen Awas Yojana. The beneficiaries in 26 districts of the state are happy after getting houses from Prime Minister Narendra Modi through video conferencing. Here is a ground report from our Ahmedabad correspondent.
In Gujarat, 1,15,551 beneficiaries have been allotted houses under the Pradhan Mantri Grameen Awas Yojana. Beneficiaries across 26 districts of the state are happy to get houses by Prime Minister Narendra Modi through video conferencing. Pradhan Mantri Grameen Awas Yojana also successfully implemented in Valsad district, where 24,747 beneficiaries have got their own house. Out of these, 22,285 beneficiaries are from scheduled tribes. Beneficiaries of Valsad district, Vinodbhai has expressed happiness after getting house under the Pradhan Mantri Grameen Awas Yojana.
मैं वलसाड धमड़ाची का रहने वाला हूँ. मेरे पिताजी मोतीलाल लल्लू भाई पटेल को प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना के तहत घर मिला है. जैसे हम प्रधानमंत्री का शुक्र अदा करते हैं, पहले हम कच्चे झुपड़े में रहते थे और अभी पक्के घर में रहने से हमें बहुत खुशी मिल रही है और हम तय दिल से प्रधानमंत्री का आभार मानते हैं.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम बेनिफिशरीज ऑफ शेड्यूल ट्राइब, शेड्यूल कास्ट एंड जनरल कैटेगरी, 862 बेनिफिशरीज फ्रॉम माइनॉरिटी कम्युनिटीज ऑल्सो गोट देयर हाउसेज अंडर द प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामीण आवास योजना विथ नवीन पटेल इन वलसाड, योगेश पंड्या, अहमदाबाद.
United States has asked Pakistan to take decisive action against all terrorist operations from its soil. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo spoke to Prime Minister Imran Khan in this regard for the first time after the cricketer-turned-politician assumed office last week. The State Department said the U.S. has long been frustrated with Pakistan's overt and covert support to the Afghan Taliban and other terror groups, forcing the Trump administration to warn Islamabad and slash military aid to the country. The State Department said in a statement that Pompeo, in his talks with Mr. Khan, discussed the issue of terrorism and Pakistan's vital role in promoting the peace process in war-torn Afghanistan. In Jammu and Kashmir, a Pakistani-origin terrorist of Jaish-e-Mohammed outfit was killed in a counter-militancy operation in Vailu Kokarnag area of South Kashmir's Anantnag district today. Earlier reports said 2 to 3 militants were holed up in the area. However, later, only one body of a Pakistani militant along with arms, ammunition and material was retrieved from the rubble of a residential house in which he was hiding and engaged in a gunfight. A police spokesman said 3 civilian protesters were reported injured during the clashes with the security forces near the gunfight site. One of the injured is reported to be in a critical condition. In Uttar Pradesh, a boat carrying 25 people, including 8 women, capsized in River Ganga in Bijnor district today. District Magistrate Atul Kumar Rai told AIR Lucknow correspondent that one person died while 21 people have been rescued. A search operation is on to find the 3 missing persons. At the stock markets, the Sensex snapped 4 days of gains to close slightly lower today, but the rupee posted decent gains against the dollar. In Asian Games, India defeated Japan by 8-0 in their third Pool A match in hockey in the 18th Asian Games in Indonesia today. Earlier in the day, India bagged 2 gold, a silver and 4 bronze medals. In tennis, the men's doubles pair of Rohan Bopanna and Divij Sharan clinched the gold, beating Kazakhstan's Alexander Bublik and Denis Yevseyev. India are now placed 8th in the medals tally with 25 medals comprising 6 gold, 5 silver and 14 bronze medals. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman assures Karnataka of all assistance in rebuilding flood-hit Kodagu region. Government approves additional grant of nearly 19 crore rupees for flood-ravaged Kerala. Enforcement Directorate again questions former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram in the Airtel Maxis money laundering case. And that is all in the news at 9. Good night.